of our first alert weather, and we are getting ready mentally, and I guess we should pack some rain gear too, but this big rain system is coming through.
Yeah, not what we need, considering all the heavy rain and flooding we had a couple of weekends ago, but we're looking at some pretty hefty rain totals. Not a repeat, I don't want to allude to that, but definitely some inches of rain are likely here with all this. Let me show you right now. Merritt Island High over to Rockledge High, Pluckenbaum Road, all the way back along the 520. This is where we're seeing some heavy rain right now. It's lifting northwest right through Cocoa. Let me show you the bigger picture. Our Doppler radar sweeping here out across Brevard and East Osceola County. As we zoom in here, you'll see these things traveling to the northwest. They're going to be getting into eastern Orange County here as we go to the early afternoon. And you see how FutureScan wants to bring some of those all the way back in toward the downtown area, over toward UCF, 2, 3 o'clock, and on into the afternoon commute. Some wet roads along I-4, possibly Seminole County, but certainly the Brevard corridor back into the Turnpike in Osceola. That's where you're going to have some of that heavier rain on into the afternoon commute. 8 o'clock tonight, notice how the rain's continuing to lift northward up the coast. So it's not one of those afternoon rain events. This is some rain that's likely to continue to develop and spread northward as this warm front comes up out of South Florida. So showers moving to the northwest through the late day, 40% rain coverage for the daytime hours, but then that rain chance increases a little more overnight tonight as a front approaches. So 81 right now in Orlando, upper 70s Sanford, Ocala 81 at Daytona Beach. Afternoon highs a few degrees warmer than we are now, despite some pretty thick clouds from time to time. 83 Melbourne, 84 Orlando. A little more sun in Marion County, so we'll put you up around 85 this afternoon. Now, the rain amounts over the next couple of days. This is really through now, through about Wednesday midday, 1 or 2 inches likely along the I-4 corridor, around 2, even possibly 3 inches of rain, where you're seeing those darker greens, depending on the track of that tropical system to our west. Now, lightning and heavy rain are going to be a concern, really starting tomorrow through Wednesday morning. Even isolated tornadoes a concern as this area of low pressure makes its way into the Florida Big Bend on Tuesday night. So anytime you have a low in the Gulf, we've got to be careful about that twisting of the winds and that tornado potential. But by Wednesday midday, colder, drier air working in, shoving all that rain off to the east, and we are going to be chilly on Wednesday night and downright breezy, sunny, and cool on Thursday. So your 7-day forecast, we have 81 at 5 o'clock, scattered showers, and then by 7 o'clock, still some rain around at 77. Coming up on your Tuesday, we'll wake up with some rain around. I'll be here to track it for you in the morning, and we'll have a wet commute on Tuesday afternoon, that possible severe weather through early Wednesday, and then we just cool down. Look at those 70s and 50s. It's going to feel like December, guys. Back